5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। मिस्टर डिप्टी चेयरमैन, दिस स्मॉल मेजर विच आई थॉट कुड नॉट टेक मच टाइम हैज बीन डिबेटेड अपॉन विद अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एंड एंथुसियाज्म। क्रिटिसिज्म हैज बीन टू फोल्ड, वन सेट ऑफ हॉनरेबल मेंबर्स हु हैव पार्टिसिपेटेड इन द डिबेट हैव पुट फॉरवर्ड द थीसिस दैट दिस इज मच टू ड्रास्टिक अ मेजर एंड दैट इट कट्स एट द रूट ऑफ द राइट्स ऑफ द लैंडलॉर्ड्स इन रिगार्ड टू द इविक्शन ऑफ टेनेंट्स विच दे हैव बीन इंजॉइंग अंडर द प्रोविजंस ऑफ सेक्शन 13 ऑफ द रेंट कंट्रोल एक्ट। वेरी लेंदी एंड एलोबरेट आर्गूमेंट्स वर एडवांस्ड, सम ऑफ देम लीगलिस्टिक, एंड अ केस हैज बीन सॉट टू बी बिल्ट ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट ग्रेट हार्डशिप इज लाइकली टू accrue to the landlords if this temporary relief is granted as contemplated by the amending bill. Then, sir, there has been another set of speakers, some belonging to the benches opposite and some of this side of the house, who have supported the measure so far as it goes, but have further taken the line that it does not go far enough and that it should be made even more stringent. If I may respectfully say that is some justification for the present measure in the form in which it has been brought forward. These violent reactions one way or the other do indicate that there can be a violent difference of opinion and difference in approach when dealing with a problem of this nature, and from the very nature of circumstances a certain amount of balanced approach has to be brought about so that the hardship to which the tenants may be exposed may be minimized, and at the same time the genuinely difficult cases of landlords may not be covered by this temporary protection. An effort has been made to strike a mean of that nature when this bill was drafted and brought forward before this honorable house. The argument that has been put forward by the set of honorable members whom I may describe as pro-landlord group has been that under section 13 of the Parent Act, after obtaining the decree of landlord will not be entitled to execute it, or if he brings forward a suit he will not succeed, and that would lead to a great deal of hardship to the landlord. All types of arguments have been advanced in support of that view. Various clauses have been examined at considerable length by two very experienced parliamentarians. They have posed a question and asked for justification of this temporary relief with regard to the cases which are covered by those clauses. The basic fact which is to be remembered while examining a provision of this nature is the practical human side along with the purely legal side. After all, it is not the government case at the moment that a case has come for doing away with the various clauses. A case, however, does exist for affording some relief, but what form that relief should take is a much bigger issue, which was intended to be thrashed out after a careful inquiry and investigation of all the relevant facts. I said at the outset that it was the government intention to go into this question carefully, and the intention is to appoint a committee upon which the various interests may be represented, and in that we also hope to be benefited by the advice of honorable members of parliament, and it will be for that committee to examine the various aspects and suggest as to what revision this way or that way towards the right or towards the left is called for, and pending that investigation there should be some relief to the people who are on the point of being thrown on the roadside. It could have been argued that the relief should have been suggested by some of the honorable members, that this temporary relief could cover all the clauses. Well, there may be some force in that, but it is a question of balancing the inconvenience caused to one group as compared to the other, and in the judgment of government, it was considered that if this selection is made and those cases are only brought within the purview of the present amending bill, whereby the landlord is not put to any real hardship, then it will be a case really for giving relief to the tenant. Now, if these clauses are examined, they will be grouped broadly under one or two categories. The position in Delhi as it obtains today is that the price of land has increased considerably. My honorable friend who sits on semi-opposition benches made out a case of imaginary hardship for the residents of Delhi. He said lakhs and lakhs of refugees have come down here and they have caused a lot of inconvenience and hardship to the old residents of Delhi. Well, some hardship may have been caused, but he conveniently forgets that it is the resident of Delhi who is the owner of small buildings.